That's a friendly target for Herbert.
33. Herbert.
This is
out.
The president
down short
of the Raider Nation. And I approve this message.
Up in the air, picked off by the Chargers. Coming back with the football.
If you're from Los Angeles,
to the end zone.
You're from Las Vegas, Nevada, and you love the Raiders, make some noise.
Stay the same, looking like I'm going to a Raider game. No, I'm not the only one. We've been doing it like this since we was hella young. I don't need a Raider patch. You know where I'm from, cause I stay in black. I'm just trying to state the facts. I never wear another color, I ain't saying that. I'm just saying I bleed silver. If you cut me, I don't need no painkiller. It's all silver and black. We could win or lose. We won 3 Super Bowls. We done paid our dues. And if they catch you trying to sneak in the back door, you mess around and get trapped in the black hole. It's Raider Nation. Yeah, we moved to Vegas, y'all. But you know this song ain't about football. You know where we from.
All we wear is Raider colors.
Now we in the Raider colors.
All we wear is Raider colors.
All we wear is Raider
colors. So we wear his black.
And has a man open. Devontae Adams.
Everything silver, black. Everything come through. Smash everything on everything. We run this town in all black. Everything. And we don't back down from anything. Vegas, my city. We everything on everything. We run this town. Oh.
It's a blackout. Knock the lights out. I'm in the stands.
What's going on, everybody? Boom! How about a big win on that big Raiders-Chargers game? Raiders still in it, and we are back for another week on the SoCal Raider Report. We've got the whole full boat here today. So what's going on, everybody? Look at that, Chandler Jones in the background. Joe, say what's up right off the bat. Get started.
What's up, brother? When you get three sacks in the first half, you get it. Get to be a big screen for our show today, baby. Come on, Chandler Jones finally came to play this week. I think it was our, it was probably our most complete game. Although we didn't start off the way we should, I think defense played fantastic and the offense came through in the end, and everything just worked out. And you could just see us coming together, 3-0, baby, 3-0, coming against the Rams this Thursday.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. All right. What about Raider Joe Jr.? We missed you last week, brother. How you doing?
I'm doing pretty good, man. Dude, I'm so hyped. The last 2 weeks been looking real good. It was well said by, you know, Raider Joe Sr. It was a very well put together game. I thought we came in swinging. And just like the Seahawks game, we went down 10-0, but I ended up on top.
Heck yeah. And what about Raider Mike, man? How's the interview going?
Yeah, interview was all right. So we'll see what's up. I'm not unhappy right now with the Raiders' performance. I think that, first two games come from behind, overtime walk-off wins. And then now we were able to create a little bit more distance and end it in regulation. Which is just, to me, further proof that we're learning how to finish teams off. We're probably going to spend more time talking about the next week's matchup, but I'm going to say that pass protection was the key to the win. A lot of great things happened, but I think the one thing that stands out to me that allowed Carr to target receivers and have a little bit of time in the pocket there was because the pass protection was pretty good.
All right. What about over there at SoFi, LA, LA John, what's going on?
Hey man, just out here with the NFL team and my Rams, hey, we won the Super Bowl last year. We're cool. Oh. We got, we got it, bro. We'll be back again. That's fine. Just relax. Just relax. All right.
Hey, well, you're probably excited. You picked up what's his name? Baker Gayfield. What's his name? No, Mayfield. Sorry.
Well, hey, Baker likes to party. We like to party out here too. Let's just keep those LA vibes rolling, baby. Bring it on, Raiders. Bring it on.
All right, man. Well, you're gonna party up in Inglewood. That's cool. All right, man. Yeah, I was very excited to watch that game. I got to spend the weekend in Cocoa Beach, Florida. Shout out to my friend Georgie, who hooked it up, even though he was very sad. He's a Chargers fan, and he was down and out. But I want to give him and his whole family a huge shout out for hosting me over the weekend. Had a great time out there. Got to do some things, did some work, and well, not a lot of work, but had a great time. So let's get into it, man. This was a great game. You're right, Joe. I think this was the Raiders' most complete game. I thought the defense finally showed up. The points that you see on the scoreboard, guys, if you didn't watch the game, it doesn't tell the whole story because Derek Carr did start off very bad.
The snap off before the play clock expires. That popped up into the air, picked off by the Chargers. Coming back with the football is Bryce Callahan to the end zone.
We did. Because you also had Josh Jacobs get a fumble too. So
that fourth quarter.
Carr. Once again, Jacobs lost the ball. It's on the turf.
A fumble and a pick six. That's not the way you want to start a game, but that's how we started. And I like the way we made that comeback. And again, I'm going to praise Chandler Jones because we've been bashing him all season, man. Guy finally came through.
Third and five. Herbert running out of time and goes down. Chandler Jones.
And, you know, maybe, you know, the lot of talk behind the scenes was he was so close. He's always so close, and he just didn't get there. And this game he got there, and hopefully that he's going to build upon that and become what we thought he was going to be.
Hey, I'm okay with losing in the first quarter as long as we keep winning at the end. You know, we're coming in strong.
Yeah, baby, I love that. That's great.
I'm okay with shitting or losing the first quarter as long as we come on top.
Amen to that. Amen to that. And you know what I liked is I saw a lot of pass rush up the middle. You know, that guy, I can't remember his name right now because I'm at a loss, but the guy we got from the Chargers, he actually, Tillery.
Yeah.
Yes. Tillery had that big push up the middle, him and Bilal Nichols. And that's, I think, what if anything, if you look back at the tape, that's why Chandler Jones got off, because those guys were pushing. Herbert didn't know where to go, so he would go to the outside, and boom, there was Jones right there.
Yeah. And I would say Mike said, I think Mike said something that I did leave out that was very evident in this game was the offensive line. I mean, you know, and you think in the beginning of the year, they made so many different lineup changes. We're getting continuity with these five guys now. They're constant, and they're starting to talk. They're starting to communicate better, and you could tell. I mean, Josh Jacobs doesn't run for so much when your offensive line isn't doing a great job.
Absolutely.
If we established the run, the trend was if Josh Jacobs ran for more than 100 yards, we won the game. Except against Kansas City, in which that was 30-29. But if Josh Jacobs is rushing for over 100 yards, we won that game.
Yep.
So establish the run, and we approach the quarterback. We're good.
But don't forget about that guy behind you, number 17, man. He is elite, and he is the deciding factor, I think, in that game.
Raiders at the 31. Carr going to go for it all to the end zone. Caught in the end zone. Devontae Adams, touchdown.
I mean, two touchdowns, two big scores, just changed the whole outcome in my mind and just kind of wiped out any chance that the Chargers had.
He is feeling it. Flea flicker. Going to throw it deep. Has a man open. Devontae Adams, touchdown.
Yeah, that was what I was getting at, too, is because we've seen, plenty of times that, we can't get to Adams, so I think what you saw was just an extra second and a half, 2 seconds in the pocket allowed him to allow the playmaker to make his plays. And that's why you've seen such a high, a completion and reception rate there.
Yes, sir. And I also think the getting Nate Hobbs back was huge. I think that, you know, the improved play on the linebackers looks like Denzel Perryman has finally showed up. And I like the way they're using him, blitzing him up the middle, and then even, you know, just seeing him and doing better in pass coverage. It's huge. So Raiders, man, I don't know, man. Looking at this game next week, is this a trap game, guys? Is this game with the Rams a trap game?
It's a trap.
I don't know why you would say trap. I mean, we're welcome you guys in there. We're just gonna take the W like we always do. That's how we do. We'll let you guys be the home team. We'll even roll out the red carpet for you, sell you some tickets, whatever we got to do.
Yeah. I'm just, you know, all these games, you know, we've done such a horrible job at the beginning of the season. And, you know, maybe that was because of, you know, like we talked about, highlighted a number of different things. Or maybe it was simply like, hey, it took a long time for us to play as a team and to trust one another and to really understand the complexity of the offense, new coach, whatever. I mean, for whatever it's worth, you know, we've lost to some teams that we shouldn't have lost to, and I'm seeing other teams beat those teams. So I'm still kind of sitting here, you know, with my arms crossed, just watching. You know, I'm not getting too high. I'm not getting too low. I'm just watching with my arms crossed, and I'm saying, okay, so far so good, 3 in a row. But, you know, we could shit the bed tomorrow, and I'm going to be just as pissed. So I don't think we're in a position where we can lose any games. Maybe, I know Joe said maybe one. I don't think that's good enough. You got to win out, I think.
And well, hope
a couple other things go well as well.
Yeah, I would say I would agree with Mike. I think that, yeah, to what I said, I do think we can lose one, but I also think that we've lost too many games already that we shouldn't have, that we can't afford to lose games like this coming up. I mean, this could be a trap game. We could think of it as a trap game because that's what it looks like, right? We should come in the way the Rams are playing right now. And the way we're playing right now, we should win convincingly, and it shouldn't even be close. So that's the mentality we need to take, you know. And we can't say it's a Thursday game; only get 3 days rest. Well, so do the Rams. So that's no excuse. Throw that excuse out the window. We can't say it's a road game because it's really not a road game. If anything, it's going to be a road game for the Rams. We just got to come in there and play. You know, go ahead, John.
Win convincingly. What NFL team has done that against any other opponent? I mean, Seattle is a very good team this year. The Rams are beat up. They have a triple backup. To underestimate your professional opponent plan for next year's contracts is a big mistake. I hope you guys do.
Yeah, I'm not saying to underestimate them, but the Saints did it to us, right? The Saints did it to us.
Yeah, and the Cowboys just did it the other day. So it's not – they're – few in between, but I get what you're saying, Johnny. It's a weird.
When I say win convincingly, look, I'm talking by winning by more than one touchdown in football. You know, that's a convincing win to me. Like this Charger game, we started slow, but we convincingly won that game. We were the better team on the field. We started off 10-0, and we ended up 27-13 at one point. So we were the better team on the field. We didn't come down to the fact we're biting our nails off for the last second victory. So I think we won convincingly against Chargers. You know, we talked about last week, Mike, that we're learning how to win after winning two consecutive walk-off wins. This win against Chargers, hey, it's showing that we're starting to win without the stressful fourth quarter in the last 2 minutes of the game. But that's a lot of the NFL, John, to your point. A lot of the NFL games this year, no matter who's playing, it comes down to it. Just like yesterday against Tampa Bay and New Orleans, yesterday came down to the last second too. You know, although both those teams are really not that good. So, but
yeah, no, but what's encouraging is the last 2 weeks, especially, these are two wins against good teams. These are winning teams. These aren't no Texas. You know, this isn't Denver. This is two good teams. Seattle's a good team, and the Chargers are supposed to be a good team, but I think most Charger fans will tell you it's been a disappointing season, even though they still have a decent record. But, hey, you know, that was a great game, but looking forward to
– two things to the table today. I did. Yeah. I wanted to how you guys see the rest of the, I know Joe's going to pick that you guys are going to win every game for the rest of the season. And then my second question, follow up to that, and you can start us off here, Ern. I know these are my two reasonable questions. Do you see yourself realistically winning the rest of the games throughout the rest of the season? And then secondly, what's a successful season? Let's say you do make the playoffs. Possibility is to make the playoffs. You got to go into either Kansas City or Buffalo, probably the road to the Super Bowl. Is that a successful season to make the playoffs?
I think I'll start with this. I'll just say that from where we were this earlier in the season, with everybody's wanted to fire the coach, everybody wanted to get rid of Carr. I think if you don't have to start over next year, if you fix the defense next year, if you work on the offensive line and you don't start over again, I think that's a success. So do I think that they can win the rest of their games? Probably not, but I do think they can make a run of it. I think maybe they could win. I think they could probably win all. I think they're going to lose one game somewhere in here. And to me, it's probably going to be against Kansas City. But I mean, look at what's going on. You know, look at Pittsburgh. That's a winnable game. Patriots, winnable game. Obviously, this week with the Rams, winnable game. And what 49ers? Else?
49ers without Jimmy Garoppolo.
Yeah.
With their whatever his name is, that guy that's there, like Mr. Irrelevant.
Purdy.
Brock Purdy. Shout out to my boy Matt Briggle, who's a big Niners fan. But who else? Isn't there one more game?
Five games. We got the Rams, Patriots. We got this in this order, the Rams, Patriots, Steelers, 49ers, and Chiefs. And the Chiefs games at the end of the season, when the Chiefs are going to be resting their players, because they're going to tie up their division in probably a few weeks here, right? So, John, my question is, do you not think the Raiders can win out? It's not that they can't. Do you think they can't?
No, I don't think that they will win out against the Steelers in Pittsburgh on December 24th. That's not fun. Who's quarterback?
Well, we did it last year, Johnny boy, and we
did. Warm weather, yes. Let's see how you do in the cold. Let's see how it happens. Let's see what happens. But I also think Kansas City might beat you just to beat you. I mean, that they do things like that. They are pricks like that.
I'm here.
And then San Francisco, that's an amazing defense. If this Purdy guy does just what he did this last game, which I have really high doubts against, but let's just say plays as well as he did last week. Well, then that's a tough, tough, tough game. San Francisco has to win too.
In home and Vegas. It's in Vegas. That makes a big difference. And you know, all I'm saying is that those last five games are winnable. We're probably going to be favored in four of the five, and you know, just go out and take care of business. But most importantly, we can't look at it like that. We got to look at it. We got one game against the Rams.
That's right.
Yep.
We definitely got to take it one game at a time. So, but I mean, you know, if we're sitting here doing predictions and stuff like that, I think the Raiders have proven that they can. Well, I guess okay. I guess I can say, well, they're all professional football teams, so any given Sunday type of thing, but I feel like the Raiders have so much talent that they can hang and beat any team, but they haven't this year, right? So we can concentrate on that, or we can concentrate on the momentum that we've built thus far. So you're right. The odds are against them winning out. But when your back's against the wall and you're living on a prayer, right? I think that the Raiders, just like last year at the end of the season, they just won out, right? What was it, last five games or something like that?
All walk-off wins.
Yeah, so we can do it again. I honestly think we can.
Yeah, and you know, to answer your other question, John, of what's a successful season, I'm telling you, if you start off 2-7 and can say you made the playoffs, that's a successful season. Yeah, going into Kansas City or Buffalo isn't ideal, but we could still win that game. But just getting to the playoffs at this point is a successful season. And the reality is, you get back into the conversation after being 2-7, you get back into the playoff conversation, you know, that's a pretty good accomplishment right there in itself.
Yeah, you know, just to also, sorry, real quick, just take a look at the power rankings, and I saw the latest ones from NFL, and the Raiders have moved up into the top 15 of teams, and they're above people that have better records. You know, there's some teams like the Giants who have a kind of inflated record that's like, yeah, but who have they beat? So, sorry, Junior, what were you gonna say?
I think a successful season is proving to the fans and to the coaches that a rebuild is not necessary. I think our players are finally, working together, and it's showing. And I don't think we need a rebuild. Maybe we need some tweaks here and there with the O-line, but I think the players are proving that they're finally learning this scheme and learning to play with each other. Rocky Sin is playing a lot better than he did earlier in the season. I think it's just going to take some time for them to adjust to this new system, just like it did for the Patriots when Bill Belichick became the new head coach for them.
Yes, sir. Absolutely. I absolutely agree with you there. That's for sure. Yeah, guys, so I don't know if you guys want to make predictions, but, you know, we're going to keep it short this week. You know, we've been on a roll. I don't want to get too ahead of ourselves. This is a short week, and I want to put the show together for the fans and make sure everybody gets to enjoy it. Appreciate everybody that's been watching and subscribing to our channel. But what do you guys think? I want to make a prediction, but I feel like I'm the kiss of death when I predict the Raiders to win, they lose. So what do you guys say?
I tell you, I predicted the Raiders to win by 10 points against the Chargers. They won by 7. I knew it was going to be a significant. I knew it was going to be a significant win for us because it's really our division game, tough game against the Chargers. I think with the Rams, it's always good to play the Rams. Rams and Raiders will be tied in history forever, regardless of where they play. But we are the much better team going into this game. Aaron Donald's out. You know, their quarterback's out. They're a mess right now. All right. So we just can't take them lightly. They're still an NFL football team. Yeah. And there's still a lot of players that are playing for a contract and where they're going to play next year. So, but I will say the Raiders are going to win by at least 10 points tomorrow or on Thursday.
Just so the viewers don't misconstrue that you have any accuracy in your picks, you've also picked the Raiders 13-0, and last season I believe the 13-3 or something. I can't remember exactly, but and every week you pick them to win. So anybody listening, there's a disclaimer. If you Ernie can edit that in there, that no one should pay. If you have a problem gambling, 1-800-GAMBLER. Please do not listen.
My brother Joe is the epitome of positivity.
That's right, baby.
Let me go next because I think what you guys are gonna like what I have to say is that a 6-point spread is very weird, especially as a gambler myself.
Is that what it is? Is that spread? Yeah.
Raiders by 6.
Raiders are favored by 6 points because Vegas knows it is a home game for Raiders. The Rams do not play the Raiders at home. Anytime that they will ever face them. So the Raiders will have home field advantage. And 6 points is a weird number. It's like a home team. If you're favored by that much, you're normally going to cover. So I think the Raiders actually probably will cover this spread. Although, here is one problem. Derek Carr's play, for some reason, on these primetime games this year seems to be a little questionable. It's hot and cold and hot and cold. I don't really understand it. So One series looks like MVP. The next series looks like third string quarterback. But that's going to be the determining factor for the victory because all the other pieces look like they're moving in the right direction. Unfortunately for the Rams, man, we're just gonna wrap it up this year. Just us and the other Rams fan, we're just gonna wrap it up and just count for next year. You know,
you and all two Rams fans, you guys are gonna just pack it in then.
Yeah, we'll just watch. We'll just watch. Probably at the snack bar. Maybe Baker buy us a beer or something. Whatever, you know.
All right. Well, anybody else want to make a prediction for the game?
I think the Raiders are going to win. I don't want to say by how much, but we are definitely a better team. Is there a chance of Darren Waller and Hunter Renfrow? I know it's not the press conferences where they say they don't want to play him, but they're technically are available for this game, right?
They are technically able to come off IR, but they said because it's a short week and they haven't had any real practice time, plus all, like your dad said, that all week is walkthroughs. I'm hearing from multiple sources, don't expect them to play. Maybe wait for the Patriots game. And then, because, you know, like I said, like we've been saying, it looks like this should be a game we could win. Next week could be a much tougher game against New England. You know, man, McDaniels versus Belichick, you know, who knows? But I think I'll be happier if they were available next week and had a good week of practice to go, because they haven't played, you know, in weeks. So
the Raider game on the road next week.
Yeah, nope. No. They're in LA. They're in Vegas against the Patriots.
Yeah, and we might have some. Joe might be there with some boots on the ground. So
I will be there for sure. I'm there.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you better. You went to the USC game, but you didn't go to the Raider game. Is that correct? Or were you at the Raider game?
What happened is I went to the SC game. I was going to go to the Raider game, but when SC got mollywopped, I had to get out of Dodge. I don't want to bring that bad mojo to the Raider game. So I went home, and then they won.
Very nice. Very nice. Way to take one for the team, Joe.
That was a tough loss for USC, but, you know, that's a story for another day. But I'm even hearing already some Ram fans talking about that they're ready to tank next year to try to get Caleb Williams themselves. Well, at this point now, I don't really care about all that. I mean, I'd love to have Caleb Williams, but I'd much rather have a Super Bowl with Derek Carr. So let's go.
Okay, so here's my bold prediction. Raiders by 2 touchdowns.
Raiders by 2
touchdowns. There you are. There you are. I said it.
All right.
Then it. What's up?
34-17 Raiders.
34-17 Raiders. Okay, well, like I said, I'm not going to make a prediction, but it looks like I will be boots on the ground for that game. Either some members of the team will be with us or maybe some family. But either way, we're excited. This has been an exciting turnaround for the Raiders and for the Raider Nation. And thank you for everybody that's been watching. Please subscribe to this channel and please give us a like. Anybody else want to say anything else before we're out tonight?
Just win, baby.
Heck yeah. Heck yeah. All right, guys. We'll wrap it up, man. All right. See you guys. We'll get back to hopefully another show next week if the Raiders pull it off. And we'll be back on the SoCal Raider Report.